dance, y'all, and we don't stop. To the beat, y'all,
yes, and we don't stop.
Yes, yes, y'all.
Yes, yes.
We don't stop, and we don't stop.
Choose him. Amen. Yes, we
amen.
Do. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Shekinah Glory Ministries. Good morning, all those that are viewing out there. Hallelujah. Good morning. I feel good and my spirit. Birds are chirping. Honey, come on now. The sun is out shining. God is good. He is
yes,
worthy
he is.
To be praised. Oh, yes, he is. And we got a dynamic speaker on here. Amen. God is getting ready to do a mighty, mighty work. Amen. A mighty word out here that he's going to deliver to us today. I just feel it all down in my belly. Amen.
Amen.
I am Pastor Carol. Amen. From Shekinah Glory Ministries, where I pastor along with my husband, Nicholas Simpson. Amen. We're going to give some clap for him. Come on. Y'all know what I call him. Amen. Hand him. Come on now. I call him hashtag my man.
Because
yes. Last Wednesday, y'all know what it is. It was payday. Get into it. Get into it.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. I got into it. So it was payday. And I always appreciate him up around the paydays until the paydays. Amen.
Yes.
We've been married for 35 years. We like to have a good time. Come on now. There's no reason being all stuffy all the time. Amen. I'm a very serious person. But you know what? It's all right to laugh sometimes and have a good time, especially in the time that we are living in. Amen. With this COVID-19. And we're almost rounding the corner. Come on now. Almost
yes.
Rounding the corner. It's almost over. I'm telling you, stay in position. Stay in posture. Don't miss your blessing. Amen.
Yes.
At the last
Amen.
Hour, don't run out loosey-goosey. And mess yourself up. Amen. And mess the
amen.
Plans that God has for you. Amen. Because they are yay and amen. And so I appreciate the man of God that would allow us and afford us the opportunity to get on here as Queen Esther's, King Ahasuerus, and say, go forth with power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost. Now, he gave me a break last week. He did that. Yes. And then on Wednesday, too, for the Wednesday Wow with him and SJP, Social Justice Pastor.
Yes.
I'm glorious. I'm bolded, amen. And I appreciate that because over here, we are on our grind. When
yes.
we go back up, we're still going to be on our grind. Amen.
Yes.
We
amen.
Have to push this ministry and do what God tells us to do. And we can rest in between, but we have to go because this is a season that's it's our reaping season. It's our moving season. It's our season to be productive and get things done. Amen.
So
amen. Can't be lazy in this season. Amen. Get with people that's not lazy. Come on, get a little rest, but get back up in it and keep moving forward. Amen. So
amen.
I thank God for him today. Amen. I thank God for the SGM family. Y'all know that I love and miss you. Me and Pastor Nick, and kisses and hugs. Y'all already know. I pray you're wearing your mask and you're being safe out there and doing what's necessary and not unnecessary things trying to sneak and creep. Because when you do that, you'll find yourself outside the garden. Amen. And have
Amen.
To do your first works over again. Don't let the devil catch you creeping and sneaking. Because he's looking and booking too. Amen. I'm
Amen.
Telling you what I'm talking about. So get ready for this woman of God. Amen. And you guys know the rules of engagement. Amen. Share, like, love, and comment. Amen. As we get forth, we're ready to bring forth this mighty vessel of God of honor. Amen. One of the daughters of Shekinah Glory's house. Amen.
Amen.
We appreciate God for her. Amen. We love her. And you know what? I'm so thankful because she's also our senior prophet. Amen.
Yes.
And a seer. We thank and praise God for her humility. We thank and praise God, woman of God, for your faithfulness, for your submission through the hard times. If you want the double portion, I say this, then you have to walk through Gilgal. And she's walked through Gilgal with Pastor Nick and I and the SGM family. Amen. And been proven worthy of this honor. So get ready as I bring forth and introduce to some and present to others, amen, the gift to the body of Christ, according to Ephesians 4, 11 and 12, the gift of the pastor, the evangelist, and the prophet. Amen.
Amen.
Phyllis Owens. Come on, give God a praise for her. This
amen.
Morning.
Welcome, amen.
Daughter.
Yes, hallelujah. Thank you. I thank you and Pastor Nick for allowing me the opportunity to go forth and allow God to stretch my gift out of me. Hallelujah. God is good. Hallelujah. I want to give honor to my husband. He's not here. Even though we're online, I want to give honor to him. Hallelujah. Hey. That is my eight-figure man. Hallelujah. Thank you, sugar daddy. Yes.
Yes.
Jeff Owens, that's my husband. I give honor to him. Hallelujah,
Amen.
Hallelujah. And everyone that's watching, hallelujah.
Amen.
I give honor and thank God for you. Thank you for
Amen.
Your presence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah. This word that I have today, hallelujah, is what I call a remix. I preached this word about 15 years ago, roughly. Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. Hallelujah. It's going to be a lot of scriptures in this. So I want you all to pay attention and make some notes. Hallelujah. I'm going to be coming from Matthew 26. Hallelujah. 39. He went a little farther and fell on his face and prayed, saying, "Oh, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." In verse 42 and 43, again, a second time, he went away and prayed, saying, "Oh, my Father, if this cup cannot pass away from me, unless I drink it, your will be done." And he came and found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. Hallelujah. May the Lord add a blessing and a reading to his word. Hallelujah, Father God, we thank you for today. Hallelujah, may you bless this word, God. May you breathe on it. May you make it come alive, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your will be done today. Hallelujah, Father God. We thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory, God. I submit and I surrender my vessel and this word to you, Father God. Hallelujah. May you edify it. May you bless it. Hallelujah. May you multiply it. May you stretch it. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Bless the people on today, God. We thank you, God, for a new day. We thank you for a new thing. Hallelujah. We thank you for new peace, new love, new joy. Hallelujah. You are definitely doing a new thing, and we receive it, Father God, just like we do this day. We thank you. We give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. Have your way today, God. Have your way. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And like I said, hallelujah, this is a remix. I preached this word 15 years ago. It's not going to be the exact same thing. Hallelujah, but God said to go in and retweak it and let it do what it do. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So when we're reviewing the scriptures, hallelujah, Matthew 26 says that, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah, prayed three times, hallelujah, but yet the Bible does not record a response. Hallelujah. And afterwards, he said, it is done, it is over. That means that God did not change his mind. He was going to have to partake of that bitter cup that he didn't want to partake of. Hallelujah. The original plan was still in effect. Hallelujah. So basically, God was saying death was mandatory and suffering is required. Jesus went on to suffer on the cross and die a horrible death for the sake of the saving of our souls, for us to be set free, for us to be made righteous through him and have a right relationship with God, the Father, and become sons of God and have access to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ's death and resurrection freed us from the fear of death because death had been defeated through Jesus Christ, through his resurrection. We must all go through an experience of dying, but it is not the end if you're a believer. Instead, it's a doorway to a new and eternal life in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. A new and eternal life in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. What is the cup that you do not want to drink of? Hallelujah. What is that cup? Hallelujah. What is that thing that you're holding on to that you don't want to die to? What is that decision that you need to make that will cause you to suffer just as Jesus did? Hallelujah. Jesus knew that that decision that God had for him, that bitter cup, it will separate him, hallelujah, from God and the people. And he loved them, hallelujah. What the same thing goes for us. What is in your cup, hallelujah? What is it that you're afraid of, hallelujah, that's going to separate you from the people, hallelujah, and separate you, hallelujah, all out there by yourself, hallelujah. A lot of times we get tied to the familiar, but God is calling us to break ties so that we can live. Hallelujah. The problem is that we don't want to go through the pain. We don't want to go through the separation, and we definitely don't want to go through the hurt. But guess what? God said death is mandatory. Suffering is required. God has given us a mandate and an order to die. And to suffer for righteousness' sake, to die to the things that exalt themselves against him, to pull down the strongholds that keep us in bondage. So death is mandatory and suffering is required. It is the only way to kill the flesh, the only way to subdue it, the only way to control it. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 10 and 5 says, cast down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bring into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, And what was Christ's obedience? Jesus was obedient as unto death. So you must do the same. Hallelujah. God is not calling us to physically die, just to let go of those things that hinder us, hallelujah, from living our best life, hallelujah, that hinder us, hallelujah, from taking hold of the abundant life, hallelujah, that hinder us, hallelujah, from having our best, hallelujah, relationship with him, hallelujah. He said, cast down those things, hallelujah. And the only way you can do it is you have to go through a period of separation. You have to go through a period of resisting, a period of denying oneself, hallelujah. Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. John 10 and 10 says, the thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that you might have life and that you may have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. So Jesus came and died on the cross that we may have life and life more abundantly. Jesus is our example. Hallelujah. And God wants us to take hold of the example that he put before us. Praise God. Hallelujah. We are to do as Jesus has done. Hallelujah. And that means that we must deny ourselves. Hallelujah. We must do that. Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. So what I'm basically saying is you must die. I must die. We must die. In order to live, we must die. We must suffer. It's just no other way out. Trust me. I fought and struggled and fought and struggled with God, just as Jesus did in the garden. Every time God comes to me and he brings up something, hey, we got to let that go. Hallelujah. I know when I'm about to go through something. Hallelujah. And and God always wants a yes from you. He always wants a yes. Hallelujah. And some things take a little bit of time for us to say yes, just like Jesus when he prayed three times. It was taking him a while to say yes because he knew that that was a horrible thing that he was about to experience. And he did not want to be separated. Hallelujah. From God the Father. Hallelujah. But we must suffer. Hallelujah. And who signs up to suffer willingly? I don't know any flesh that wants to just die. Hallelujah. Nothing. Suffer means to permit, to allow, to endure, or to experience hardship. Who wants to just sign up for that? Hallelujah. So sometimes God got to press and he got to push on us. Hallelujah. To get us to say yes. Hallelujah. Yes, yes. Just as Jesus did, where I asked the Father, is it any other way? Because I don't want to experience this pain, God. I don't want to experience this loss. I don't want to experience this separation and this heartache. Hallelujah. I don't want to be looked upon as different. Hallelujah. I don't want, hallelujah, to be separated. Hallelujah. Oh, no, no, no. We don't want to go through that. No, we don't. Hallelujah. We don't want to be uncomfortable. We don't want to be by ourselves. Death is a lonely process. Hey, it's a party of one, baby. Although something may be good to us, it may not always be good for us. So it's time to let it go and to die to it. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory and suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why is it so hard to die to certain things? Because they make us feel good. Because they comfort us. Because they allow us to hide our true selves. Hallelujah. We've gotten so used to those things. But God is calling us to die that we may live. We need to allow the Father to kill every stronghold in our lives. Kill every wrong mindset, change it, develop, hallelujah, something different in us, hallelujah. Mindsets that we, hallelujah, develop from being in a wicked and ignorant environment of people who was just unlearned of the things of the Lord, hallelujah. Bad habits that lead to addictions that cause sicknesses and even worse, death, a bad attitude, ungodly soul ties, generational demons, hallelujah, generational iniquities like jealousy, stealing, and lying, lust and perversion, hallelujah, fear. The list goes on and on. What I'm trying to say to you today is that we all have some type of stronghold. We all have some type of issue. And God the Father wants us to cast it down. He wants us to kill it. He wants us to let it go. Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. When you choose to die, you go through a season of being broken. That is a part of the journey, part of the process. Jesus was broken. He was bruised. Hallelujah. I said yes to the process of death. Hallelujah. And through that process, hallelujah, I got broken. Hallelujah. And if you're not being broken in the process, then you haven't said yes to God. Hallelujah. I got humiliated throughout that process. I was misunderstood. I was rejected. Hallelujah. It brought about a death within. Hallelujah. Jesus went through the same thing, and he paid the ultimate price, which was death. Hallelujah. But he conquered death that I may live. So I can go through the process and yet live. I can go through the process and yet take hold of the abundant life. Hallelujah. Because I am allowing God to do what he needs to do within me. And that's what God is saying to us today. He's saying the only way out is that way in. It is the way of death. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. So we must yield to the breaking and we must submit to the process. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. So what I'm saying today is God is calling us, the called, the chosen, to pull down the strongholds and to let it go. It is a call to suffer just as Jesus did on the cross. If God did not allow Jesus to forego the cross, then he will not allow us to forego our cross. Hallelujah. We must take up our cross and we must move. Hallelujah. Matthew 16:24-26. Then Jesus said to the disciples, if anyone who come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. For whoever will save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? What shall a man give in return for his soul? Hallelujah. What shall you give in return for your soul? What is worthy, hallelujah, of you paying the price for your soul? Nothing. Take up your cross, hallelujah. What is it that God is saying? Deny that, daughter. Deny that, son. Go this way. Don't go that way. Leave that alone. Move from over there. Let them people go, hallelujah. What is it? Take up that cross. Take it up and follow him. Follow him. Hallelujah. Don't try to hold on to the life that you know of. Hallelujah. Let it go so God can give you that abundant life. He said anyone that holds on to their life will lose it. But anyone that loses it for my sake, hallelujah, you will find life. He said you will find abundant life. Hallelujah. Thank you. So God is saying today that we must die in order to live. And Jesus showed us how to do that. He wants us to die to self, die to our wants, die to our desires. Allow Father God to give us new desires. Hallelujah. Our heart's desires will change. Hallelujah. When we surrender to his will and we surrender to his way. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. 3 John 2 says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou may prosperous and be in health, even as thy soul prosperous. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My soul is yet being anchored, yet being delivered, yet being healed, yearly, monthly, daily, hourly, as I allow God to process me. Through each and every storm in my life, hallelujah, that God allows to come my way, hallelujah, my soul is being healed. It's being anchored, my God, being delivered. And that's what God wants to do, because he wants you to prosper, hallelujah. God is settling me. He is settling you. He is establishing me, me with my fickle and wavering soul. Hallelujah. The word of God does not change. It stays the same, my God. It is steadfast. It is unmovable. Hallelujah. Despite the tides and the waves that come into our lives, God will allow the storm to rise up in our life, to wake up that stuff, to break up that stuff, hallelujah, that's in our soul that needs to be delivered, needs to be healed, needs to be set free, my God, so that we can live the abundant life, hallelujah, the abundant life, hallelujah, hallelujah. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. How many know that your soul can't prosper if it's bound up? Hallelujah. You must be healed in your soul so that you can live the way that God intended. Hallelujah. God is calling us to die to soulish things, to those soul ties that created strongholds in our lives, to wrong agreements, hallelujah, that we made through either wrong living or unholy covenants, hallelujah, that we made with others, hallelujah, by leaning and depending on someone other than God, hallelujah, by making someone else our first stop instead of making God our first stop, hallelujah, that's creating idols. God is trying to pull down those idols. He wants to be first in your life. He wants to be the one that we call on. He wants to be the one that we need. He wants to be the one that we trust. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No more idols. Cast them down. Cast down those altars. Cast down those wrong, hallelujah, and unholy covenants. Hallelujah. And wrong agreements. Hallelujah. That we have made. Hallelujah. Put God first place. Hallelujah. That you may worship him. Hallelujah. In spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. God wants to correct all of those things in our lives. Jesus is Lord, not man. Jesus, he wants to be Lord of your life because he wants you to have the best. Hallelujah. So you got to cast down those imaginations. You got to deny yourself. You got to take up your cross. Hallelujah. And you got to follow him. Though the way may be hard. Hallelujah. Though the way may be treacherous. Hallelujah. You got to do it. Praise God. You got to do it, beloved. If you want to see God's best, I want you to have God's best. I've been on this journey for a while. Let me tell you, I preached this message 15 years ago. Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. God said, there's no way, daughter, that you can get around it. There's no way, my God. I'm calling you to that. Hallelujah. We are the called. We are the chosen. If you are the called and you are the chosen, my God, then you're called to die. You're called to this, my God. Not just me. You're called to this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory, my God. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory. It is mandatory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's no way of getting around it. No way, says God. Hallelujah. This is what I called you to do. Just as I called my son to do the same. Hallelujah. Follow him. Follow Christ. Hallelujah. Follow Christ, not man. Follow Christ. Hallelujah. If man is following Christ, then by all means, follow man. But follow Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, because God wants us to worship him in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The soul must surrender to God. That's the only way. That's the only way. Hallelujah. Be just as Jesus was. Say, nevertheless, God. not my will, but your will be done. Hallelujah. We got to take on that same approach. Nevertheless, nevertheless, hallelujah. We must take that on. Hallelujah. That's the only way that we, hallelujah, will partake of kingdom living, kingdom ways, doing things the way that God wants us to do it. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you for your word. So God is saying, I want you to be not just a reader of my word, hallelujah, not just a hearer of my word, but a doer. I want you to apply this to your life. Hallelujah. I want you to execute this in your life. Hallelujah. Apply it to your situations and watch it work on your behalf. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, because God said his word will not come back to him void, but it will go and accomplish where he sent it. So we have victory over all things, inward and outward, because of Jesus' death, because of what he did, hallelujah, on the cross, because of his resurrection, hallelujah. So in order for the soul to be set free, delivered, and healed, we must go through a dying place. Just as Jesus did, we must do that also. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus can show you where his grave is at, but can you show someone where yours is at? Hallelujah. Can you say to someone, that's where I died, right there. I died right there. That right there, that situation, woo, that caused a death in me so great. Hallelujah, that it took me to the grave. Hallelujah. Show them where your grave is at. Where your grave is at. If you can show anybody where your grave is at, then you have not died. You are yet still dying. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. Hallelujah. There is no anointing without the death process. No power, no authority without denying oneself. God cannot use you as a vessel of honor to help others. Hallelujah. If you don't go through the death process. Hallelujah. Jesus is the anointed one, and he has the anointing. And in order for you to receive it, you have to do as he did and partake of it. How much Jesus do you want? How much Jesus do you want? Are you willing to die? Are you willing to sacrifice? Are you willing to deny? Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Get with him and get to working some things out in you. Hallelujah. That you may live the abundant life here on earth. Hallelujah. Not when you die, not in the new life, the abundant life on earth. He said, I came. Hallelujah. That you may have life and that you may have it in the abundant. Hallelujah. So he's saying in the land of the living now. In the land of the living now. So it's all up to you. All up to you. Yes, it is. So I just stopped by here to tell you today that God has not changed his mind. Death is mandatory and suffering is required for the anointing that destroys the yoke to be available and to be present in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God wants us to get into it. Get into this dying process. Let him separate us. Hallelujah. Let him bring us closer. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Romans 8:2 says, for the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus have made me free from the law of sin and death. That's what the death process does. That's what it does. It brings you into the life of Christ Jesus. And it brings you out of the law of the sin and death, my God. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. So God is after those things that lay dormant in us, people. That tradition that we hold dear. Those people who are toxic, to say the least. Hallelujah. That we can't separate from. Hallelujah, because they're our family and we love them and we don't want to be without them and we don't want them talking about us. Hallelujah. And saying, oh, we think we better or she thinks she too good. Hallelujah. Y'all know that choir I'm talking about, them and they. Hallelujah. God wants you to forget about them and they. Hallelujah. And think of him. Surrender to him. Submit yourself to him. Submit yourself to the process. Submit yourself to his way. Let him process you. Hallelujah. Let him deliver your soul. Heal your soul. Hallelujah. That you may prosper and have the abundant life, my God. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is coming for those things in us, beloved. Hallelujah. Because he wants us to be free. Totally free. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 5 and 17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ Jesus, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Hallelujah. That's what Christ is doing for us. That's what God is doing for us. This is a renewal scripture. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Coming from one old mindset to a new. Hallelujah. Because when you decide to take on and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you become a new creature. And so you start to go through the process. Hallelujah. It's all in you saying yes. When God brings it to you, all in you saying yes. We got to let go. Hallelujah. We got to let go. We got to lose it all. We got to allow God to strip us of some relationships, strip us of some people, strip us of some bad ideas, some bad thinking. Hallelujah. God wants to strip us of the things that we put in place above him. Hallelujah. He said, cast down those things that exalt themselves against him. Hallelujah. And John 12 and 24 says, truly I say, except a corn of wheat falls into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. Hallelujah. If you die, you cannot live. You cannot be a blessing to others. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. Unless a corn of wheat falls into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. Hallelujah. God wants you to bring forth that fruit today. Hallelujah. So he wants you to go ahead and die. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. It is required. So what is in your cup that you don't want to drink? What is it you're not willing to die to? What is it you're not willing to suffer for? Hallelujah, that you may live and others may live. Drink what is in the cup, beloved. Drink what is in the cup and take the separation. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. I got blood on me because I've been around Jesus and Jesus is bloody. I've been in his presence. Hallelujah. I'm all up in his face. Hallelujah. I'm in his will. Hallelujah. That's why I got blood on me. I'm bloody just as Jesus is. Jesus is making war on our behalf. Hallelujah. That's why he is bloody. Hallelujah. And if you're going to get, if you're going to be like Jesus, you're going to get bloody. You got to die to some things, beloved. It's going to hurt. It's going to cut you. Hallelujah. But God is a healer. God is the one, hallelujah, that's in control. God says there is life after death. There is life after death. Hallelujah. Daughter, I want your soul to prosper. Son, I want your soul to prosper. You got to let go of this thing. You got to die to this thing, beloved. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory. It's the only way. Suffering is required. There's no other way. There's not a plan B. There's not a plan C. How much Jesus do you want? How much of them do you want? Hallelujah, hallelujah. You want to be a son of God. Hallelujah. You want to partake of the things that Christ says is available to us. Hallelujah. You got to die, beloved. You got to die. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the name of the Lord. So like I said, God gave me that word about 15 years ago. Hallelujah. And I've been going through the death process. It's a continual process. It's consistent to say the least. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But I went through this message and God say, hey, preach that message, add a little bit to that daughter. Hallelujah. And tell them in the end, hallelujah, that you are no longer, hallelujah, accepting that death is mandatory and suffering is required. You have accepted it. You have walked through it. Hallelujah. You are an example. Hallelujah. I've paid the price. I have went through the pain. I have gone through the suffering. I can tell you, you're going to make it out. I can tell you, you're going to make it through. I can tell you there's life after death. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why one time I was getting ready to preach and God said, tell them you're a boss. You're a boss. You're bowed, obedient, submitted, and surrendered to me through Christ Jesus. I'm no longer accepting, hallelujah, and fighting with God about this death process. Hallelujah. I accepted it. I yielded to it. I bowed to it. Hallelujah. I'm obedient to it. I surrendered to it. I submitted to it. And that's what God wants you to do. That's what God wants you to do today. Hallelujah. Death is mandatory, beloved. Suffering, it is required. There's no way around it. There's no way out of it. Hallelujah. Except a wheat of corn goes into the ground and die, it abided alone. Hallelujah. God wants us to abide together. Hallelujah. And that is the word of the Lord. Death is mandatory. Suffering, it is required. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes. Let me tell you something. Now, you know this is one of my favorite messages.
Yes.
I don't like it.
Yes.
I don't like it.
Right.
I don't. But, yes. You know, I've learned over the years, and I say this, I have a 40-year tenure, and I have learned in the last 35 years, like you said, death is mandatory, and suffering is required. And a lot of times, the people don't like to suffer, people don't like to go through, but the point is, if you want God's choices blessings, for your life, it is going to be required. You just said it. You cannot get away from it. You cannot go around it. You cannot go under it. You just can't. You have to obey God when you're in it. And let me tell you something. Everybody is not going to have and complete that full circle of 100. Bible says 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold. Everybody's not going to complete the 100-fold, but I can tell you this, be the best you. If you're on the 30, just know every level requires a certain amount of suffering. Every level requires a certain amount of pressure that seems to them, even though it's 30-fold, it seems like to them that it's 100-fold, because God knows our capacity to stretch us. He knows how much he can stretch us, how much he can press us, how much he can push us, how much we can endure, because the Bible says he'll put no more on us than what we can bear. But
amen.
I can tell you this, he will press you from the inside out. Even, let me tell you something, there's no amount of prayer, no amount of fasting, no amount of being in your word and prayer that's going to eliminate what God has to put you through. It can make it better for you, because you won't lose your mind. You won't make it more tumultuous for yourself, because when we start going through stuff, we run off the beaten path, because the Bible says the Bible says the word is a light unto our path and a lamp unto our feet. So a lot of times we get angry and we try to run off the path. And then you run off into some darkness, pick up some more devils that God didn't put on you to make you. And then now you have to contend with those devils and the devils you picked up. Amen. Because you was angry. So I would admonish and I would encourage you guys to stay on the beaten path. What a wonderful word. I know it doesn't feel good. Let me tell you something. All of us are going through something even now. That's why we have to ask God to give us Jehovah Shalom, the God that will give us peace. We have to have peace, because what happens is, once we're in the mouth of that thing, once we start that thing or in the process of that thing, God will give you peace that surpasses your understanding, because your understanding, your intellect, your natural intellect will not comprehend that this thing is so natural. This thing wants me to knock people out, cuss people out, come on now, do all sorts of crazy stuff. These things do. But guess what? When you begin to look out and see Jesus and him high and lifted up, you'll see God in it. You'll see his purpose in it. You'll see his hand in it. You'll see that he is doing this thing to press on you as a person. Come on now. It may start out here, which a lot of times it does, with a them and the they. But after a while, when you begin to pray like you're supposed to, get in that word and in prayer. Now, those are what these tools are used for. You begin to see a little bit more clear that God is summoning you. He's calling you in and saying, I want to handle you. I want to deal with you a little bit further, to take you a little bit further. Because you, when you drink of that bitter cup, like the one that God says, then it's getting up and come on. And then you got to get on up that hill with your own cross. Come on now. It's just what's got to happen. So I've learned to say, God, I don't like it, but I welcome it, because I don't want to be like Forrest Gump, handicapped with them handicapped shoes. Now we're going, I know they say she's going to talk about that death and that suffering, and she's going to talk about dying, and she's going to talk about that character. I am. Come on now. Okay. And because the Bible says, except a grain of seed fall into the ground. They got to go into, not to it, but into and die.
Yeah,
alone. You can't bring forth life. You can't tell people nothing that you ain't been through.
That's amen. Right.
And so I'm gonna talk about it, because I've been through it. Come on, and I yet go through it, yet dealing with some stuff now. But guess what? I have inner peace that continues to jerk me back in line and say, hey, where's your mind going? Come on, burn that up, because God only uses all those things to burn off the dross. Hallelujah, on the inside of us. Come on now.
Yes.
We think we made right. We think we got it going on. We think you, and God will put that fire just to show you, if you look at it with a great mind and a perspective. So God has to clear up our vision like Samson. Clear up our mind. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. He got to clear up our mindset
so
we can understand God's ways and not our ways. He said in Isaiah, therefore they're higher than ours. But we want to have it so easy, but we want the best, God's choices, blessings. You'll never get it. We want to be boss? No, no, ma'am. No, sir. Until you be, like she said, I used to tell her, I said, woman of God, you are boss too. Well, no. I said, yes, you are. And I said, because God had given me I'm boss, because I can bow in adversity. And as I kept telling her in the process of what she goes through, and just whatever, because there's so many processes that you have to go through to get to. So many processes, I said again, that you have to go through to get to. So therefore, every time a process came up and we just wanted to talk about it, I said, you're boss too. And God gave her the acronyms for what the adversity means to simplify it for all of us.
Hallelujah.
Be bowed, obedient, S submitted, and S surrendered. I'm talking about in the midst of adversity. A lot of people said, I'm just going to be an employee still. I'm not the employer. I'm not boss yet. Because let me tell you something. When you break it down and people can really catch it on their level of intellect and how they comprehend, they will then say, I'm going to wait my turn and not try to overstep God, overstep people, have this aside, doing stuff they know they have not acquired that level. I always say, I'm a woman of influence, and so are you, woman of God, and a lot of others that are looking on. But and so when you are influential in the secular arena, the world, the natural, and in the spirit realm, God taught me this in my 20s. He said, first of all, don't take your influence everywhere to advance or let people think that that avenue or that place where you are, Carol, is okay. He said, so be careful how you use it, because I'll get you if you use it the wrong way. Because we can validate a certain person, a certain thing, a certain place, if we use it the wrong way. Yes. So what we need to do is be careful. That's why God has to burn us from the inside out so we can walk in the right character, hear him, and have a balance on how we do stuff and not take advantage of it and what you call it, abuse our authority, abuse our influence. Because once you walk in that room in the natural, the whole atmosphere will recognize who you are. You don't have to throw no airs. You don't have to try to do so such and much and be all that. It will speak volumes. You hear what I'm saying? No, let me tell you something. I can guarantee y'all this. If you get into some understand and bow to this and be bowed, obedient, and walk in the submission, walk in love, walk in character, those are the three principles I will walk in for the rest of my life and have been for the last 30. Can I tell you the devil will never overthrow you, and I guarantee. Now, I use two words I don't often use, never and guarantee. Never, because the old folks and anybody will tell you, oh, don't use that word never, because you will eat the N-E-V-E-R, all caps, with three exclamation points. God will force them down your throat, and the devil will knock them on down there. You will eat that never. Yes. And so I'm very cautious about that. And guarantee, because I came out the industry of finance, stock, bonds, and securities. And they tell you, because I was a compliance officer, you use the word guarantee, it flags your emails. It flags your communication, because you never can guarantee a customer the rate of percentage rate on the return of their monies, because the market is always fluctuating with the percentile and percentages, because of the mortgages, because of annuities, because of stocks going up and down. So when it's encompassed in a mutual fund or something like that, you can never promise and guarantee anything, because it's too the market is too volatile. Amen.
Yes.
And so I said, so I learned not to use those words loosely, and just and to be cautious when I use them. But I can use them here because I've experienced it, and God told me, I guarantee you, and you will never be overthrown. And I guarantee you, the enemy won't overthrow you. Never will do it. Guarantee you, it will happen. It won't happen if you walk in love, submission, and character. Get into it.
Yes.
And to get those things, to acquire those principles in your life, will require death processes time and time again.
Yes.
Over and over and over. And if you're repeating some things that look like a repeat, because we become repeat offenders. We become repeat offenders, and don't get mad when you get three strikes and you're out and you go in prison for a minute. Come on now. Can you hear me? Do you got Metro or Verizon? Can you hear me? Huh?
Yes.
I've been a repeat offender. What about you, woman of God?
Yes, ma'am.
Come on, God said you didn't get it right the first time, Carol. So I got to dig a little deeper in you.
Yes.
Dig a little harder. And it's already sore. So we need digs in there, because God, I dig that thing up, because you want his choices, blessings for you.
Yes.
So surrender to the pain, because no pain, no gain.
Yes.
I don't like it, but I welcome it. Come on, and get you with some people that's not idiots, and get to running off, speaking in tongues, binding up the devil. And the devil can do some stuff, but God is in it. When we get done with our conversations, associate pastor, what is the conclusion of the matter? I say, God is in it. You say, I know he is, pastor. The process, the pain of the process into purpose. Therefore, you can enter into your destiny. Amen. That will take you further, and you won't be mediocre. Come on now. I don't know about you. I'm not mediocre. Come on now. So he gonna press on me and say, what? What you gonna do, Carol? He said, what did I tell you? Much given, much required.
Yes.
So I will bow down to his will.
Yes.
His hand of suffering. See, I'm gonna preach on that hand. It's very tumultuous sometimes.
Yes.
The hand will crush you, kill you, and press out the best oil of the anointing in you.
Yes.
Come on now. But it will always, at the end, raise you, encourage you. Come on, lift you. Come on and bless you ultimately.
Yes.
That's what the hand will do if you take it. Come on now.
Yes.
So get with people that can encourage you and let you continually see and keep your vision straight, your ears open up to hear God, that it is his will concerning you. Amen?
Amen.
So Amen. This has been the most powerful message, woman of God. I'm going to let you wrap it up. Death is mandatory and suffering is required. That is the thing that makes you boss. No way around it. No way out of it. Come on, just walk on through it. We here for you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. So God is saying, how much Jesus do you want? Ooh. Hallelujah, how far are you willing to go? Hallelujah, are you going to allow me to deal with you? You're going to allow me to touch that thing, says God. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah, it's all up to us. Hallelujah, that's where that yes comes into play at. Hallelujah, with God tugging on you and pulling on you to say yes to some things. Hallelujah, yes, walk this way, daughter. Yes, leave that alone. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Yes, get over here. Hallelujah, yes, I know you by yourself. Yes, I know you're lonely. Yes, I know you're afraid. Hallelujah, but this is the way that I called you to go. Hallelujah, how much Jesus do you want? Hallelujah, I got some things for you. And that's what God is saying. Hallelujah, he got some things set aside for us. Come hallelujah on. In 2021. Hallelujah, but we can't lay hold of them because we got a little lazy. Hallelujah, we wasn't represented by being with each other. Hallelujah, we was had the there was no integrity to log online, says God.
Come
hallelujah.
On.
Hallelujah. People didn't always log online for Sunday service or
come on
Wednesday. Wow. Hallelujah. God said, I saw you. I see you. No, they didn't see you, but I saw you.
Praise
God. So God said, what I'm telling you now, what the woman of God came to tell you, no, it's not an easy word. It's not a nice word. Hallelujah. It's not a pleasant word. But God said, line it back up. Surrender, submit, get back in line. Hallelujah. Or you're going to forfeit those things that he had already set aside for you.
Come
hallelujah.
On.
He said, get back in line.
Babe.
Get back in the process. He said, I see you above all, says God. Line it up, says Lord. Line it up. Not an easy word. Hallelujah. But it's an on-time word.
Come
it's
on.
A good word.
Yes.
Death is mandatory. Suffering is required. He loves us. Go through the death process. He's waiting for you at the end. Hallelujah. When you go through that pain and go through that suffering, he's waiting for you. It'll be a sigh of relief. Hallelujah. I made it through that. Hallelujah.
Ooh.
Because one thing I don't want to ever let go on this walk with God is Jesus. I don't want to let go of God. I can let go of anything else, but I don't want to lose him. Hallelujah. How much Jesus do you want? How
Mama.
Willing, how far are you willing to go? Just say yes. Death is mandatory and suffering is required. God say, line it back up. Get back in line. Hallelujah. He's still pressing out the oil. He's still doing it. Hallelujah. Get back in line. Yes, it's been some shaking. It's been some shifting. And now he's going into some sifting. But God said, get back in line. Get back in order. Hallelujah. So that you can get his best. Like Pastor Carol said, his best. Hallelujah. Not just the minimum, but you want the maximum. Life abundantly. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
My is choices, blessings.
Yeah,
that's what I want this season. Why go through and get the very minimal?
Right.
And if that's okay, if that's for some people, that's what they want, because some people just don't like to go through. They can't take it. They can't stand it. And I'm okay with that. But get out of my way. How about that?
Yes.
Get out of her way. Get out of the other way.
Mm-hmm.
Like Tabitha Brown say, if you're not having a good day, then she lowers her voice.
Yes.
Don't go and ruin nobody else's.
Amen.
And that's what people do. They get mad because you will go through the fire, the flood, swim through the snakes and the alligators, and get to the other side to give God's choices, blessings, and then they'll get in there and try to wreak havoc and do some stuff in this season. Don't do it.
Yes.
Don't get in my way. I'm telling
yes.
you now. Move on
yes.
out the way. If you want 34, I'm going into 60 and 100. Just get out of my way. Leave me alone and leave me be. And let me go ahead and go through what I'm going through to get God's choices, blessings. Amen.
Yes.
Let
Amen.
Me be able to be free to get his choices, blessings. And it looks like because I'm down now. See, when Joseph was in that pit, They just was assured that God's word was not going to come to pass, and they were not going to bow in obedience to him. But baby, come on now, SJP, Social Justice Pastor brought it right into play again.
Yes,
they, when they went over there and didn't have no food and didn't recognize who Joseph was, they had to bow in obedience.
Yes, they did.
They had to bow.
And
they had to surrender. That's what obedience means, bowing and surrendering
and
obeying. And they had to bow to the man of God, their own brother.
Yeah,
all that so they can be fed. And again, I say, when you go through this process, do not give people all of the blessings God has bestowed upon you. You don't owe them nothing but love. I will tell you this, you don't owe them nothing but love. Joseph gave them enough to be sustained and maintained. You better hear me. I'm gonna leave it right there because I'm gonna preach that thing. SJP brought it back up again, and along with what you're saying right here, woman of God, I'm gonna thrust in that thing and give people the revelation of what God was saying. Because he'll chastise us for going above our his compassion. Because his compassion will do what it's doing to us right now, putting us in line, shaking us, making us, purging us, cleansing us, purifying us, and putting the fire on us here and there. That's what his compassion, God, will do. And he don't want no one in the way to mess up his process. Amen?
Yes.
He wants us to do his will, and it comes through doing that. The Bible says, I believe in Psalms 119:71, it said, it was good for me that I have been afflicted, that I may obey his statutes. That's been my scripture since I was 25, 26 years old. And folks couldn't understand it. What Sister Simpson talking about? This suffering and stuff. Well, guess what? If he gonna beat you with that flask and burn you from within and put that pressure on you through the death and the suffering process, you will not obey him.
Amen.
And therefore, you'll bring yourself to a demise. Amen.
Amen.
And complain that you don't have God's choices, blessings, because you wouldn't bow down and obey. It's not them and they fault, the devil fault, God fault. It's a decision that we all have to make. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Associate Pastor. This has been a phenomenal word. Amen.
I heard
it all them years ago because I've known you for a long time. And baby, it's just relevant now. And you put a spin on it today.
Yes.
Oh, my God, how much Jesus
do you want? Yes.
Come on now.
Yes.
You know she called between the social pastor and the prophet. She just be in there. Throw a little evangelist word in there to let us know, to encourage us.
Yes.
I pray you have been encouraged today,
Amen. Men
and women of God, SGM family, those that are viewing. This has been the most powerful, dynamic word. You guys know what time it is. We love God. It's time for the seed. Amen. Seed make you boss. Amen. Please go to our website at www.shekinahglorylv.org. In the right-hand corner, there's a donate button. Press that, put your tithes and offering in there, and drop us a seed if you're looking on and viewing. Don't eat for free and leave and tip out with the Baptist finger. Come on, be a blessing. Plant your seed. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you again, mighty woman of God, for that anointed, powerful word. Death is mandatory, and suffering is required.
Yes.
We do love you. God bless you. Until next time, I'm Pastor Carol. We'll see you on Tuesday at 6 to 6:15 p.m. for prayer time with that woman of God, the warrior. Amen. Another warrior, Evangelist Angeline Worthington. We love you guys. We'll see you later.
Amen.